fodder scam now back to haunt Lalu Yadav as the Supreme Court orders another trial for Lalu, which will have to be completed within 9 months. What does this setback mean for the Mahagathbandhan in Bihar? Nitish Kumar has maintained a studied silence.
The fodder scam back to haunt Lalu Prasad Yadav. Today, the Supreme Court ordered another trial for Lalu in the scam, overturning an earlier Jharkhand High Court ruling. The trial has to be completed within 9 months, and that could mean fresh trouble for Lalu, who was convicted and sentenced to 5 years by the CBI court in 2013.
Lalu Yadav had to step down as a member of parliament in 2013 following his conviction. The conviction also meant that he could not hold office for 11 years. Currently, his sons are in the ruling coalition government in Bihar.
Politically, the new trial could spell fresh trouble for the ruling alliance in Bihar, where Chief Minister Nitish Kumar was forced to join hands with Lalu to take on the BJP in the 2015 state elections. Nitish's party gave a guarded response, while the Chief Minister has stayed silent.
Adalati mamlon mein kisi ko bhi dakhal dene ka adhikar nahi hai. Hum sar jhuka karke adalat ke har faisle ko swikar karte hain. Aajkal CBI ki sakriyata badh gayi hai.
Will you also keep quiet today? And the larger question is, to what extent are you willing to compromise your political integrity to remain in power?
Lalu himself stayed indoors today, only meeting his lawyers and interestingly expelled JDU leader Shivanand Tiwari. Ironically, Tiwari had been one of the complainants in the fodder scam, but fell out with Nitish Kumar, who expelled him from the JDU.
Gathbandhan atoot hai aur 2019 mein sab miljul karke sirf Bihar mein hi nahi sare desh mein jo hai hum log Narendra Modi ka mukabla karenge aur unko parast karne ki koshish karenge.
The Supreme Court order also comes as a blow to the opposition at a time when Lalu has been in the forefront of efforts to forge an anti-BJP alliance ahead of the next general election. With Manish Kumar in Patna, in New Delhi, Siddharth Pandey for NDTV.
We're joined on the buck stops here by the face of the BJP in Bihar, former Deputy Chief Minister Sushil Modi, a man who's actually worked closely with Chief Minister Nitish Kumar when the NDA alliance ruled Bihar. Thank you for speaking to us, Sushil Modi ji. Can Nitish Kumar, in fact, continue with Lalu Yadav as a political ally? Can he keep silent now, as he seems to be doing?
See, Nitish Kumar will be the happiest person today. Because if Lalu Yadav becomes weak, it will be easier to tame his sons, it will be easier to control his party. So either it is exposure by one of the channels having connection with Shahabuddin, or his property, more than 1,000 crore property being exposed by BJP. Or today's decision of Supreme Court, today's order of Supreme Court. So Nitish Kumar will be the happiest person because he wanted Lalu Yadav to kneel down before him and support his government. But I don't think Nitish Kumar will be able to continue with his government, and there is a political instability within the alliance partners. The kind of infighting, the kind of Cold War going on inside the alliance.
Okay.
It will be very difficult to complete his complete term of 5 years by Nitish Kumar.
Okay, now that's very interesting. You're saying a weaker Lalu Yadav is actually in Nitish Kumar's interests, with these embarrassments piling up one after another for Lalu Yadav, making him weaker. Nitish would actually want to continue.
Yes.
All right, but if, as you say, that there is a cold war between the allies and the Nitish Kumar government will not last its full term, is the BJP ready to support Nitish Kumar?
See, now BJP is so powerful in Bihar. So it is not BJP of 2013 when BJP was a junior partner to Nitish Kumar. And if elections take place today, the BJP along with its alliance partners can romp home with two-thirds of majority. So now it is not old BJP, it is a new BJP in Bihar. So it is not the question of supporting any alliance in Bihar.
But
and because the mandate is for JDU, RJD, Congress. It is not the mandate for BJP and JDU to run government in Bihar.
Now, that's as it may be, but you are not entirely ruling it out either. If Nitish Kumar is in a situation where he would need the BJP support, is the BJP categorically ruling this out?
So, you don't rule anything in politics. If Nitish Kumar can be with BJP for 17 years, even after Narendra Modi, even after Godhra, Nitish Kumar was with BJP. But as on today, it is a hypothetical question. But what happens, when happens?
Yes. Okay, that's very interesting. You're saying a weak RJD is in Nitish's interest. You're not categorically ruling out the BJP eventually supporting Nitish, even though you say that the BJP is in a position where it doesn't need to do so now and it would get a two-thirds majority if elections were to happen in Bihar right now. Isn't the BJP, though, actually helping to weaken Lalu Yadav further? You don't seem to be targeting Nitish or his party in the same way that you have gone after Lalu or his family.
Now, for the last 18 months, we are targeting Nitish Kumar. It is only the last 1 month when we are exposing the land deeds of land scam of Lalu Prasad Yadav. But we have always opposed Nitish Kumar as well as Lalu Prasad Yadav. So there is no question of not attacking Nitish Kumar or showing any mercy towards Nitish Kumar, because he is heading the government.
But you've also claimed Nitish Kumar was aware of Lalu Yadav's phone tapping.
See, please tell me, in a state like Bihar, any tapping can be done without the knowledge of CM? He is the home minister of Bihar. He is looking after the police. And Shahabuddin was already on surveillance. So, Nitish Kumar knew about the talk, and this is not the only tape. I know that more than one dozen of such tapes of Shahabuddin talking to Lalu Prasad Yadav and some other people. So already Shahabuddin was on surveillance, and Nitish Kumar knew Shahabuddin talking to Lalu Prasad Yadav, but he remained silent because he is not in a position to act against Lalu Prasad Yadav, because if he dare to act against Lalu Yadav, his government survival will be in peril. It will be difficult to survive his government. But he kept silent, and when now it has been exposed, so now he's blackmailing Lalu Prasad Yadav by not taking action.
Blackmailing.
So that Lalu Yadav kneels down before JDU and support Nitish Kumar in fulfilling his so-called ambition of becoming Prime Minister of this country.
Okay. Sushil Modi, very interesting points being made by you. Thanks so much for joining NDTV and sharing your views about that. Let me also at this point bring in Pawan Khera of the Congress. Remember, the Congress is part of that Mahagathbandhan in Bihar today. The RJD, of course, not speaking at all, but even Janata Dal United, Nitish Kumar's party, keeping a very low profile. Also joining us tonight from the BJP, GVL Narasimha Rao, but we've just heard at length from Sushil Modi. So I want Pawan Khera to respond first. Is the ruling alliance left weakened today, Pawan Khera? Is it in Nitish Kumar's interests, or for that matter, the Congress's interests, to be allied to a weakened Lalu Yadav, as the BJP seems to be suggesting?
No, the BJP is very good at pipe dreams, and they're welcome to their dreams. But to the best of my understanding, the courts have ordered a trial. They haven't convicted Lalu Prasad Yadav. I don't know why the BJP wants to jump the gun. And why should the alliance be under any threat? I fail to understand that. Mr. Sushil Modi had a huge thesis on his political understanding of the situation. And I think he was actually he was dreaming aloud when he said that, a weak Lalu is an asset for Nitish, and so on and so forth. I mean, all this is kite flying. It's in the realm of speculation. Let the trial go on. Everybody respects the judiciary. Who are we to even comment on it?
We're not not commenting on it,
but
Pawan Khera.
One more issue.
Pawan Khera, do you not believe that this spells a huge threat really to Lalu's political career? if indeed he is convicted for the sake of the argument and is sentenced to anything more than 2 years in jail, that means he will be debarred again from running for elected office for another 5 years. So where does this leave him politically?
Mr. Amit Shah was behind bars. He was a tadi par. And look at his political career. He's doing so well. And of course, the CBI is very selective. When it came to Amit Shah, the CBI forgot to appeal. And Amit Shah is scot-free. When it came to Advani ji, CBI went and filed an appeal. When it came to Lalu Prasad Yadav, CBI jumped the guy, and filed an appeal. So, this so-called caged parrot, I guess, is enjoying it, being in the golden cage now. CBI is at the beck and call of this government.
GVN Narasimha Rao, come in on that. The Congress seems to think that this is merely a trial, not a conviction. The BJP is jumping the gun. If anything, the CBI is going only after opposition leaders. How do you respond?
Yeah, first of all, the Congress government was given strictures by the court, the Mumbai court, for attempting to really implicate our national president, Amit Shah ji, mainly as a political machinations. If they have any shame, they should not talk about it. Because I can show the order to them.
Sorry, but the CBI didn't even go and file an appeal.
They've done it as a conspiracy. That is the judgment of the court.
It will open a Pandora's box.
I didn't interrupt him. Please, I asked him to keep quiet.
No, no, the judgment does not mention that. You are misleading the country.
Let me complete my statement.
The judgment does not mention this.
Let me complete my statement.
The judgment does not
Ankita, that's not
gentlemen,
fair.
Gentlemen, you can't be heard. Pavan Khera, you'll get a chance to respond.
TV.
Please let...
No, you cannot do that.
Please let GVL Narasimha Rao finish.
He cannot lie here.
Yes, go ahead, GVL.
Okay, because the court passed strictures against the Congress government for implicating, for trying to implicate Mr. Amit Shah, I had to expose them. Number one, there were strictures. I think if you have any shame, don't talk about it. If you have any shame, don't talk about it. Coming back to the case today, the case today, Lalu Prasad Yadav is already a convict. Lalu Prasad Yadav is already a convict. But he has been convicted by the CBI court,
special
court, and for 11 years.
I can,
Ankita, this is unfair.
You do your homework.
Okay, I want to put a different question to you just to get out of it. Gentlemen.
I expect you to do better homework than this.
Okay, gentlemen, a grand alliance in 2019.
Just let me complete my statement.
May I interject with a question here?
You can't get away with lies.
All right, GVL Narasimha Rao, Pawan Khera, a grand alliance in 2019. The opposition coming together to take on the Prime Minister.
Can I make my statement first?
Lalu has been key in forging such alliances.
I have not spoken yet.
GVL Narasimha Rao, Pawan Khera.
I have not made my statement.
Yes, please go ahead. Please go ahead.
Let me complete my statement.
Has the Honorable Supreme Court
stopped Lalu Prasad Yadav? Lalu Prasad Yadav, can I, Ankita, this is typical Congressy style. Because the facts are so embarrassing. The Congress is neck deep in corruption. They have an alliance with Lalu. They don't want others to speak.
I don't know what he's talking about. I think I'm
gentlemen,
responding
I'm only
to your
actually
new question and he's still...
No, I only now have time to get last comments from you. This is futile. I'm going to quickly ask a question now. A grand alliance of 2019 of the opposition coming together to take on Prime Minister Modi. Lalu Yadav could perhaps have been key in forging such an alliance in the past. Pawan Khera, is this going to be a problem for you if indeed he is convicted?
There are too many speculations in your question. A, will there be a grand alliance? B, is he the one? I mean, there are so many people playing so many roles. C, will he be convicted? So I can't respond to 6 or 7 speculations in one question. I mean, politics goes on. Lalu Yadav has not been barred by the Supreme Court to do his politics. To fight the forces that he's been fighting so effectively against. Has he been stopped from doing that? No. So where do these questions come from? I don't understand.
Okay. The Congress doesn't have an answer to what it thinks are speculative questions, but presumably this is going to be important going ahead. GVL Narasimha Rao, I'm going to give you last comments on this show. Go ahead.
No, you see, if they wish to have an alliance, they can still continue and they can have an alliance in jail because Rahul Gandhi, Sonia Gandhi, and all of them, even Lalu, they're all facing charges of misappropriation, breach of trust.
What
criminal
rubbish
cases
is he talking about?
In
what
court.
Rubbish is
and
he talking about?
And if they all give
what
the same kind of judgment, they can
you
have an LA in jail.
You take the ED and the CBI.
This is not going anywhere. We're talking about Lalu Yadav. One last question to both of you.
How can he accuse my leadership of corruption? How can he do that?
National
what
Herald.
What National Herald? There is no
National
case there.
Herald
you will see
case.
That.
You okay, I'm going to, I want to have to close this debate.
To Robert, you keep court. Coming up with new things.
It is very unfortunate that the RJD refused to talk today,
first,
as did the JDU.
You first see what Amit
the
Shah
Congress
is up to.
And the BJP refusing to talk on the matter at hand. I'm going to close this discussion. Pawan Khera, JVL Narasimha Rao, thank you for joining us on this show.